So on this particular episode, I did hear about a particular book, and I was like, you know what? I really want to read this book. And so I knew that I didn't have the budget for them. With everything that we are doing, you're going to see videos that are going to actually illustrate, you know, so pay the rent, the internet, and buying the sound blankets that we've been doing, and also getting the booth built. It's just a little bit turning out to be a little bit too much. And I also had to pay a subscription for the StreamYard, which is the software that we use for Saturday live streams. You'll understand why I totally did not have the budget for this thing, but I'll show you all those finances later on. Just asked if anybody wanted to get me this particular book. Okay. Amazon Prime. The order is here. So thank you very much to Sister Nandi, who made the funds available. Sister Nandi gave me access to her account, guys. And so you have to be a preacher. You have to really mean what you say, because people give you like, she just gave me access to an account which had a lot of money inside it. And this book was only about $500. And so I was like, wow, people really do trust US is a man of God. You are out there talking thing. Yeah, people do trust you, and rightfully so they should. But unfortunately, many of them charlatans be out there taking advantage of people. So highly appreciate Sister Nandi for this particular one. So we gotta go and okay, once I hold it like this, something is wrong. Okay, so we gotta go and do the do's and bring. Okay. The book, it's not straight, guys. So is this book right here. So what is it about this book? As you can see, the title is Engena Selekganyane and the Early ZCC Unauthorized History. So you're getting a direct look into what actually happened in the beginning of the church and all that kind of stuff in this book right here. So we can put this one here away, which is for opening packages, nothing else. But this book here, been looking for it. It costs about $34 for everything, but it's 200 and something for the book, and you're gonna pay average of about 200 and something also for the shipping. And so thank you very much, Sister Nandi. I would not be able to do this review, so this video is extremely important. So what kind of things are in this book, or what got me interested in this book particularly? He illustrates this in about three sections. So I'm gonna put it in three sections. So I'm gonna put up three sections for why I think that book is that important. First of all, he illustrates it by expectation. Okay, so expectation of what you're gonna see. He's not trying to highlight, oh, they're wrong on this doctrinal error, they're wrong on this doctrine, they're wrong. He's not trying to illustrate that. So that's important. Why? Because that's the expectation that I am the one who is going to bring. I expect to understand what kind of doctrines they drew from. So the expectation wasn't for him to illustrate that. I needed him to just state the history, which is what he seems to be doing in this book. It's just labeling. Okay, they did this, they did this, they got this type of things from here. Like for instance, when he illustrates that the reasoning of giving, they were given, I found this very funny. In the summary, they were given particularly for their ancestors and for him to then mitigate that entire thing. Now the Bible is completely against that, to say there's only one mediator between God. He's not talking about that. He just tells you for what reason certain things were. And so I'm just giving you that download so that you can understand why to expectations to have and all that kind of stuff. And so for me, I wasn't expecting him to talk about, oh yeah, this is wrong from that doctrinal error. No, he only labels what they do inside there. So which I thought was good, because then it benefits both the one who believes and the one who doesn't. The falsehoods and the dangers, right? So remember, he's not labeling that. That's what we will then pull out of it. And so the falsehoods and the dangers are the mixture aspect. When he talks about how Lahayana was going through different churches in order for him to derive certain pieces of doctrine. He wasn't like going to one area and getting all his doctrine. which is what you kind of do when you're actually fixing your doctrine. So he would leave Zioni and then go to AFM and then find doctrines in AFM, pick what he likes, and then take something from Zioni and then bring that in, which is not what you do. Okay, especially when it comes to denominations. This is what's important about denominations. If in case you were not clear, why is denominations important? We can't all be one. We ought to be divided. Even in Genesis, when Babylon actually broke down, this becomes dangerous, because when he's taking doctrines from a false, or from where he was chucked out or kicked out, he then confuses it with another thing from another church. So for example, the issue of ancestors, he goes to Zioni and then he finds the issue of ancestors, so he takes that. But then he goes to Faith Mission, he finds faith healers or Presbyterians, he finds whatever form of doctrine that he finds over there, he infuses it with African traditions. He goes to another one where he finds healing, and so this traveling, wandering aspect of him, I feel like it's the foundation of ZCC. It's the confusion of doctrine, and it presents a lot of dangers, because then you are not only thing, like if you go from one charismatic church into another charismatic church because the teacher here is wrong and he's trying to put himself over the word of God. So when you get to the other church, you find a church where they actually exalt the word of God above what man says, which is the confusion that is here. Now, remember, he's only illustrating the history. And so when you get there, you're only going to see the history, which is why I value that. And so I'm extremely grateful for that. So the dangers is that the mixture, therefore, this mixture perspective, for me, it's going to drive people. It drives people crazy, and it drives people towards false doctrine. Now, my conclusion on this, which will be section number 3, is this shows you why a lot of leaders, churches start on the wrong note. He gets kicked out of so many. But for him, starting it on the note of copying, copy this. He's never taking from one branch. He's taking that from there, that from there, that from there, and then he brings it into one. Now, this might be beneficial if you're taking this principle from here, which is biblical. Take this principle here, which is biblical. He's not doing that. He is mixing denominationalism into one whole mess. So basically, find something in AFM, find something in Zion, find something in African traditions, and he mixes that and he makes it a religion. Which is why I wanted to get the book, because at that point it was like, wait a minute, how much does he mix? And how badly does it get theologically? And so I'm very excited to read the book, and I will give you my full review after reading the book. So if you want to go get it, you can go get it. For me, it was this point here when I saw how mishmashy he was getting, and I was like, whoa, is that really what happened? And so that was my interest for getting the book. And so I'll give you a few reviews once I'm done reading the book. I'm going to be doing them highlightings and all that kind of stuff, and then I'll give you a down break of the book. I won't give you every single part of the document or of the book, because hey, it's someone's work, and I feel like, you know, go buy the book. It's someone's work, so do give credit to where credit is due. That type of history, for me, I did see some other people were giving links for, hey, go read it over here. I'm sorry, I'm not interested in doing that. He might provide that kind of a value to say, you know, you can go get it, get the free version. I feel like compensate towards his work. Okay, and so Siriki is a reality show. We do daily Christian commentary videos. Like other videos that are done today, will be done in the pinned comments. The confusion that is at ZCC gets much more deeper. That rabbit hole, we'll tread it, and we will get back to it from a perspective of what the Bible actually say. What should he have thought after learning from an apostolic faith mission view and then finding a Zion view about ancestors?